What could possibly be more frightening than climate change, biological warfare, dying, and, wait for it, Obamacare? What about clowns? Hi, Jokers, it's Natalia for D News. A legitimate phobia of clowns is called coulrophobia. Although a lot of people are creeped out by clowns, full-blown coulrophobia is not a common phobia. However, with the rise of creepy clown sightings across the US and parts of Britain, we wanted to know, why are people so afraid of clowns? Is it an innate fear or a fear born out of horror films like It and Killer Clowns from Outer Space? Well, there's actually some science to back up why so many people are creeped out by these merry pranksters. A 2008 British survey of approximately 250 children found that nearly all of them thought clowns, regardless if they were intentionally scary or not, were creepy. But how could Bozo the Clown be in the same category as Pennywise from It? An attribute of many clowns is their unwavering dedication to sticking with one emotion. A sad clown is always sad. A happy clown is always smiling. They wear their emotions like a mask with painted on makeup, and you don't really know what's going on underneath. This creates something called de-individuation, which is when an individual's identity is obscured. This applies to everything from burglars wearing masks to individuals commenting anonymously online. Trolls. Evolutionary psychologist Glenn Gare said that people who are in a state of de-individuation are more likely to engage in despicable behavior like cheating and stealing. So when we encounter someone like this, we, quote, expect them to act at their worst. Now, humans don't do well with uncertainty, including unpredictable behavior. In a study released by New Directions in Psychology, researchers argued that creepiness was a byproduct of ambiguity. People feel fear when they know something is going to hurt them, but if they're unsure of someone's behavior, the mere threat leaves them creeped out. According to the co-author of the study, psychology professor Francis T. McAndrew, clowns are, quote, mischievous, which puts people constantly on guard. Think about it. You never know what you're gonna get with a clown. I mean, geez, if a clown car pulls up, you don't know if you're gonna be ambushed by 1, 5, or 30 clowns. Talk about uncertainty. For somebody with coulrophobia, a clown car is the ultimate nightmare. Now, clowns also fall into a psychological category called Uncanny Valley. Freud came up with the term uncanny to describe the phenomenon that humans experience when they see something that is familiar, but is somehow off. And the term Uncanny Valley was first coined by a Japanese roboticist, Masahiro Mori, and includes almost human-like creatures that aren't quite human. They sort of trick our brain, which in turn creeps us out. Like lifelike animatronic humans, or a ventriloquist dummy. Clowns are human, but they're an exaggerated version of ourselves. That makes them fit into the Uncanny Valley valley. And a lot of clowns are stuck in a permanent smile. When somebody smiles at you, your brain often interprets it as a nice, safe gesture, but the brain can detect a fake or an unnatural smile. According to Harvard professor of psychiatry, Dr. Steven Schlozman, your brain recognizes that when someone smiles all the time, there is something off, as with clowns. Makes you wonder what their true intention is. Do they want to hug you or murder you in your sleep? Mwahaha. So if you have a mild to severe fear of clowns, you're not alone. But remember, clowns are people too. Even the creepy ones. If you want to know more about the Uncanny Valley and its effects, guess what? We have a video that goes into more depth. And what about you? Do you like clowns, dislike clowns, or are a clown? Tell us in the comments below and be sure to like and subscribe for more D News every day.